Hi, I'm Tyson Parker with Good Day Fishing. I had a couple of our products here that I wanted to show you today. The big one being our quick release. So we all know these 360 flashers are really hot right now. For today, I'm using Mack's scented flasher as an example. The big problem with these is they put such a heavy load on your line when you're fishing them that it's easy for the fish to get slack behind them and spit the hook, or you're just busy fighting the load of the fish plus the load of these flashers. So what we came up with was our breakaway. So when the fish hits, it breaks away. The flasher now just flops out of play and you're just fighting directly on the fish. It'll help increase the number of fish that you land by not allowing them to get the slack that allows them to spit the hook. And so one of the big key features of ours is the screw right here. It makes it adjustable tension. So if you're fishing shallower waters or running some heavier gear behind this, you can snug that screw up just a little bit right there and then it won't release until you want it to. And once you set it, you can forget about it. It has a nylock on the back and that won't go anywhere. They come preset right at the right tension for your normal conditions and then you can fine tune from there. So now I want to show you how to install the quick release on some of the most common flashers. For Mack's, they come with just the one dual lock and swivel on the back. For this, we will swap and move that to the front. And then you'll have to add your own clip to the back. So now the quick release comes with both a swivel or a split ring and a dual lock on the front. The split ring will be used only for the pro trolls. The dual lock is what you'll use on both Mack's and short bus. So when you're running Mack's or short bus, you can just take that split ring off and just keep it for using whatever you want. For that, you'll just clip in just like that, right on top. Then we come back here, you'll just hook that through and pinch it shut. That leaves the new swivel on the back with the body running behind your clip here. The one thing to watch is if you run too long of a clip here, you won't have enough slack for this to release. So when you have it pulled out tight like this, you want there to still be a little bit of a gap there to make sure that it releases correctly. You can run a little bit smaller clip, but you don't want to have a ton of extra play in this line or else it can wrap around. So the idea is just keep that about a quarter inch. When that ball pops out, you want about a quarter inch there. And then once again, there's the set screw that you can just do small moves to adjust the tension. They come preset. You don't have to touch them unless you have an issue with bouncing bottom or anything like that where they're releasing before you want them to. Now for the Pro Troll, it's a little bit different. So for the Pearl Troll, we actually will remove this whole ball bearing swivel because they have the solid ring here. So to do that, if you line up, most any pliers will work on this, but if you line up right over the top of the split ring, right where that goes on there, they just pop off. So now, take your quick release. Like I mentioned before, for the Pro Troll, we will be using that split ring to attach it. So up here at the front, like I said, now you can remove that clip and use it for something else. Come up here with your split ring pliers. Attach it just like that. Then we'll come back down here to the solid ring. Hook that on there and pinch it shut. Just like that. Now, one other thing that we offer our Pro Packs. And so what these are, they're a pack of three of just the bodies. So if there's something that you want to rig up differently, or if there's a different style of flasher that you want to try these on, or any other use you want to use this on, you are able to buy a three pack of just the release body for whatever use you want to use those for. Another product I wanted to show you today is our Good Day Fishing hand wipes. Now some of you might be familiar with these as we've had them out before, but we just now brought them back. The main purpose of these is to eliminate all the foul mammal smells off your hands that drive fish away and replace them with the scent of anise. What that does, the anise oil will replace the human oils, will keep your hands from drying out, and will replace the foul smells with anise oil that's actually a fish attractant. They're also great for cleanups around the boat, where there's little drips and spills from running eggs, from plug cutting herring and running bait, to wiping down your gear before and after fishing. There's tons of uses for these on and off the boat.